Introduction. It's a great pleasure to give a talk in this conference in honor of Yuri Kabanov, and I especially thank the organizers. So our motivation comes from the following problem. Assume that you have an exact diffusion model with high complexity coefficients. The question is how to select a simplified diffusion model within a class of models under the constraint that the probability distribution of the exact model is preserved as much as possible. For this, we need to consider a distance which matrices the weak topology. The Wasserstein distance W2 matrices the weak topology on the set of probability measures on square integrable passes. Unfortunately, numerical computation of W2 on an infinite dimensional space is not possible, or at least very difficult. This is why we introduced a new distance. We introduced a new distance, but not on the set of all probability measures, but on the set of probability distribution of strong solution to stochastic differential equations. And this new distance will be defined by restricting the set of possible coupling measures. Like the classical Wasserstein distance, we will prove that this new distance matrices the weak topology. And furthermore, this new distance is a value function of a stochastic control problem, and classical results do not apply to the corresponding Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation, especially because the differential operator is degenerate. Nevertheless, we can prove that this Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation has a smooth solution. And finally, we exhibit an optimal coupling measure. So first, we define this new distance W tilde 2. So this distance will be defined on the set P of probability measure P mu sigma x, where P mu sigma x is the probability distribution of the unique strong solution to the stochastic differential equation with coefficients mu and sigma and initial condition x. So the equation is written here. And we assume that mu and sigma are Lipschitz and sigma uniformly strongly elliptic. So we start with this set of probability measure. Then on this set of probability measure, we will define our new measure. And for this, we will start by defining the set of coupling measures. So given two probability measures in this set, P mu sigma x and P mu bar sigma bar x bar, we construct the set of coupling measure. It will be the set of probability law P tilde of the couple xc x bar solution to the following system of stochastic differential equation. Here we have written the equation of x bar, which is just related to mu bar and sigma bar. And in the equation of xc, you see that there is this process cs, which is predictable process with values in correlation matrices. And the Brownian motion w bar s and ws are independent. And I recall that the set of correlation matrices is a set of matrices, D by D matrices, such that there are random variables, X and Y, satisfying these conditions. The expectation of X transpose X is equal to the expectation of Y transpose Y is equal to the identity matrix, and C is the correlation. So we deal now with this set of probability measures, which are the laws of the solution of this couple of stochastic differential equations. And now we defined our distance between P mu sigma x and P mu bar sigma x bar as the infimum taken on all this probability distribution of this integral. And then we take the square root of this expression. So you see it is very similar than the definition of the Wasserstein distance W2, but here we restrict to these coupling measures. So of course, because we restrict to this coupling measure, and it is easy to see that the marginal distribution are p mu sigma x and p mu bar sigma bar x bar. So it is very easy to tell that we have this inequality. Furthermore, we can prove that W tilde 2 defines a distance on the set of probability measure p mu sigma x. And furthermore, it matrices the weak topology on the set of probability distribution p mu sigma x with coefficient mu and sigma uniformly Lipschitz bounded and sigma uniformly strictly elliptic and x belonging to some compact set. And now the important point is that we can interpret W tilde in terms of stochastic control. So now this new section is aimed to prove that the value of W tilde 2 of p mu sigma x, p mu bar, sigma bar x bar can be obtained by solving a stochastic control problem and that the corresponding Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation admits a regular solution. So we introduce for t less than capital T, this set add t capital T, which is a set of predictable processes C theta with respect to the filtration generated by the Brownian motion starting from time t, and which take values in the set of correlation matrices. There is a unique strong solution for every process CS. At t capital T, there is a unique strong solution x c theta x bar theta of this system of equations, and where ds and cs are related by this equation, and we consider the corresponding objective function, which is a minimum taken over this processes c theta in at t capital T of this expression. The corresponding Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation is the following. In fact, we have written it this way because the generator is in general degenerate, and in the correlation appears also in the volatility term, and we have split. Therefore, we have split the generator in two parts. The first part, which is a non-degenerate generator, and another part, which is written here, which is the part containing this correlation matrices. In fact, it is we cannot use a classical result to solve this Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation because, in general, it is degenerate. And we will study first the one-dimensional case because in this case we can completely solve the problem, and we will see that in this case the generator is degenerate. So in the one-dimensional case, we can assume that sigma and sigma bar are non-negative because the law of x of p mu sigma x depends only on sigma square. And so now we consider the family of stochastic differential equation x star theta x bar theta solution to this system. Here you see we have taken the case where the correlation is constant equal to 1. We consider the corresponding function v star of t x x bar, which is this expectation. And this function is a unique classical solution to the parabolic partial differential equation, which is written here. You see that here you have the generator L v star, which is the same as before. And here we have this term, which corresponds to the correlation equals to 1. Furthermore, in this case, we can compute this second order partial derivative. Indeed, it is given by this formula minus 2 times this integral. Here we see that there is the derivative of the flow, and the derivative of the flow is a stochastic exponential. Therefore, this term, d2v star, dx dx bar, is always strictly negative. So we have exhibited a classical solution v star to this equation, because here the minimum corresponds is attained for c equal to 1. And if we write the corresponding differential equation, we see that it is given by this formula. And of course, these two columns are proportional, so the differential operator is degenerate. So in general, the differential operator will be degenerate. So now, in order to study the multidimensional case, we consider the Hölder space. So I recall here what is the definition of the Hölder space. First of all, I want to insist on the fact that the Hölder space, C0 alpha, is a set of continuous bonded functions. Boundedness is included in the definition. And so C0 alpha is a set of continuous bounded functions such that for every t, phi t point is Hölder continuous of order alpha, and it is equipped with this norm, norm phi 0 alpha, which is defined as a sup of norm infini plus the Hölder term. The Hölder space C alpha over 2 0 is defined similarly, and C alpha over 2 alpha means the intersection of these two spaces. And then C1 plus alpha over 2, 2 plus alpha is a set of continuous bounded function phi of class C1, 2 with bounded derivatives, and such that dt phi, the partial derivative dt phi and d2 xi xj phi belong to C alpha over 2 alpha. And then it is equipped with this norm, which is the sum of all the infinite norms plus the Hölder term. So now, we can prove this following result. Assume that the function mu, mu bar, sigma, sigma bar are in the Hölder space C alpha of Rd for some alpha strictly between 0 and 1. Assume that the matrix valued function A of x equal to sigma transpose sigma A bar equals to sigma bar transpose sigma bar satisfies the strong ellipticity condition, which is written here. Then there exists a solution V to the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation that we want to solve, such that V belongs to C1, 2, and such that this function V, normalized by 1 plus norm of x squared plus norm of x bar squared, belongs to C1 plus alpha over 2, 2 plus alpha. In fact, why we need to divide by this term, it is simply because in the right-hand side of the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation, we have some term which is not bounded. And in order to construct a bounded function, we divide by this term 1 plus norm of x squared plus norm of x bar squared. So I have a recall here what is the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation. And in order to solve this equation now, we will consider this equation here with a generator simply, which is considered as a non-degenerate part, LV, and we will consider that this term is an additive term. And so we will construct some fixed point method, starting from some V, solving this equation Diront T capital V plus L capital V plus H of T x x bar small v equal to this term, and then we will prove that we get a fixed point. In fact, because the term on the right hand side is not bounded, instead of starting just with V, we will start with V divided by 1 plus norm of X squared plus norm of X bar squared. And because we prefer to have a condition written at time zero, also we inverse the time. So this leads to consider the following partial differential equation. We start from some function v tilde, little v tilde, and we construct the solution capital V tilde to this equation. So to do this, we consider the set K of function g tilde belonging to C1 plus alpha over 2, 2 plus alpha, such that the Hölder norm is bounded by some constant exponential, some constant times t minus 1. And in fact, we can prove that if V tilde belongs to K, there is a unique solution to the above system, which was this one. And if we denote psi tilde of V tilde as a unique solution to the above system, we can prove that psi tilde defines a continuous map on K with values on K. Furthermore, we prove that this set K is convex and compact, and then we can apply the fixed point theorem from Kakutani and Glicksberg in order to have a solution to our equation. So we have proved the following result. Assume that the function mu, mu bar, sigma bar are in the Hölder space C alpha, with alpha strictly between 0 and 1. Assume that sigma transpose sigma, sigma bar transpose sigma are uniformly strongly elliptic. Then there exists a regular solution V to the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation, which is Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman that we started with V in C1, 2, and such that the function V divided by 1 plus norm of X squared plus norm of X bar squared belongs to C1 plus alpha over 2, 2 plus alpha. And the term H is this one, as it was written before. So now we want to construct an approximating sequence for this distance. And for this, first of all, we make use of Michael selection theorem, which asserts that, in fact, there is for every n, there is a continuous map Cn taking values in the set of correlation matrices, which is 1 over L optimal in the following sense. Cn satisfies this equation. And so now, making use of Cn, because Cn is a continuous map, we know from result of Struck and Varadin that there exists a weak solution to the system of stochastic differential equations, which is written yn, y bar n. And if we consider pn, the law of this system, then it follows that this quantity converges to w tilde 2 of p mu sigma, p mu bar sigma bar to the square. Sorry. Merci. So So now, making use of scorecard result, we prove the existence of a process XI and the sequence XIN, all of them defined on some probability space, such as that the finite dimensional distribution of XIN coincide with the corresponding finite dimensional distribution of YN, Y bar, B bar, B. And furthermore, xi n theta converges in probability to xi theta for every theta. And then we can also prove that there exists a predictable process xi star and an adapted and continuous solution to the system x star x bar, which is written here. Where C star here is here the correlation matrix, and C star belongs to the argmin, and which satisfies this equation. So we have found an optimal coupling, which is a predictable process. So now the conclusion. We have introduced a Wasserstein distance, W tilde 2, on the set of strong solutions to stochastic differential equation. This distance is defined by restricting the set of coupling probability measure to laws of stochastic differential equation. And we have proved that this distance matrices the weak topology and that it is the value function of a stochastic control problem. This value function is the regular solution of Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman, and we have construct also an optimal coupling measure. And this optimal coupling measure can be approximated by diffusion laws with continuous coefficients. So thank you for your attention.
I think that the result on Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation has a certain relation with very old results by Krylov. So wherever...
Excuse me?
By Nikolai Krylov. Do you know that maybe in the 70s there was an activity how to find solutions of Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equations with even with degenerate coefficients? And so this resembles a lot some results of Krylov.
In fact, we have looked carefully at literature, and we have not found something which can be applied to our case, in fact.
Okay. So it does not cover it
no.
by Krylov. Okay, thank you. That's my
So my question is that in one-dimensional case, the optimal coupling is the correlation is just one.
Yes.
And my question is that in multi-dimensional case, actually,
no,
do you have
it cannot
some,
be generalized.
I mean, do you have some example that where the some correlation not one is optimal or can be believed to be optimal?
Yes, in fact, we have seen that in a multidimensional case, one of the problem is the non-commutativity, because if we would have started with some sigma and sigma bar, such as that for every x and x bar, sigma and sigma bar commute, then you can decompose them, and then you can do the same as in dimension one. But in dimension greater than one, in fact, it is... We cannot have, in general, that the optimal is obtained in with a correlation matrix equal to one. It's not true. And furthermore, for example, what would be very interesting should be to prove that the matrix D2V over DX, DX bar is invertible. This is true in dimension one, but in general it does not seem to be true, because if it was invertible, then we can simplify the proof a lot. But it does not appear that it's true.
Thank you.
think that is a big gap because one-dimensional case and multidimensional case, especially because of this non-commutative point.
Do we have some other remarks? Yes.
Just please bear with me.
Natural mic.
Oh, sure. So it just since you find out at the end that the solution exists and is smooth enough.
Yes.
Okay. So do you have, for example, can you consider some example for those for that C those H function? And you can get explicit solutions, especially because you have the right term is if you take D equal to 1, that means dimension 1 is like a polynomial.
Yes,
that
yes.
Nice. That's what I mean.
Yes, I think that in general it is very difficult to write a solution. But the interesting point is that we can construct also a family CN which is continuous and such that the corresponding term has a limit which is this distance W2 to the square. But in general, we cannot write what is C star and
thank you.
And it seems also that in general, it is not true that C star is just a function of S, X, X bar. It is some measurable process, but it is not Markovian.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. So.
Is there any hope of going to less regularity on the coefficients? Mu and sigma. The assumptions are very strong. Is there any hope of relaxing that?
In fact, even in order to prove that we have a distance, for example, to prove the triangle inequality, it seems to be difficult if we do not have some regular property. So.
You started out saying that as motivation that the Wasserstein distance is difficult to compute.
Yes.
So could you just comment on how practically you apply this result? Say you have an equation and you want an approximation by epsilon.
We have written the problem as Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation, then it is... it is easiest to do computation.
But you have to solve the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation,
yes,
to get to know how close you are with your approximation.
Yes,
is
yes.
That,
yes.
Is that physical in practice or? Say you go the other way around, you say,
I want
an approximation by epsilon, how should I choose the approximation so that I get? Is distance less than epsilon?
Yes, in fact, it is to solve the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation. Yes, we do it with a method of fixed point, and then we construct a solution which for which the limit is a solution to the Hamilton-Jacobi-Bellman equation. So numerically, you can also do this. Doing this fixed point model method, and then you can see how close you are from the solution.
Do we have some more questions or comments? So if not, let us thank Jocelyne once more.
Thank you.